Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and I'm here today with a co-worker in the ministry and a good friend, Ryan Chan from Hong Kong. Welcome, Ryan.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Ryan's been working with me, alongside me in the tennis ministry for a few years now. I've been very fortunate to have him, and I'd like to hear a little bit about him. I'd like you to learn about him, and also about tennis in Hong Kong and China. He's been able to do tennis. He's a tennis coach here for a number of years, and he's also gone over to mainland China and done some training over there. So we'll get a chance to talk, to ask him some questions today. Ryan, tell me a little bit about yourself. You're married. Tell me about how long you've been coaching. That'd be interesting.
Yeah, I get married in 2008, and I do the coaches about 5 years.
Five years ago.
Yeah.
And are you the member of some organization?
Yes, I have two licenses, a PTRO, Professional Tennis Registry, and Modern Tennis Methodology Coaches Association. Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about, you know, you're a Christian, obviously, and tell me a little bit about, you know, is it difficult to use your faith with, say, sharing with the other coaches in Hong Kong? Tell me a little bit about that. What's the difficulties of that?
Yeah, difficult is at the Sunday is the church day. Okay, the coaches for the survive they're not easy to go to the church because when you invite them to go to church at a Sunday, they will struggle with, I have lesson on Sunday. So when you want to share this gospel, it's not easy because you have to build a relationship. But coaches have a build a relationship is difficult because at the Chinese culture, they will compare. Okay, you are good, I'm not good. So compare with other people. So if you want to share the gospel, be a defense, you have to make a long time. So it's like that. The difficulty is like that.
Built on relationships over a long time.
Yeah, because compare. So I'm a coach, you are the coach, and you're fighting, you're like the right. War, okay, you take my student, okay, so it's not easy,
right.
be a group, it's not easy.
Yeah. Okay, well that's interesting to know. I'm sure that's similar all over the world, that coaches sometimes, you know, are fighting for students and income, but on the other hand, as brothers and sisters in Christ, we should be able to get along. Now, one thing in Hong Kong, do they have church services besides Sunday? So, I mean, you know, it seems to me like coaches could say, I'd want to go to church on Wednesday.
No, Monday and Wednesday have, at the night time, have worship. Have
some churches
at the Sunday have a service.
Yeah. So maybe the real situation is the coaches just don't want to go to church, actually. Okay, if they have a choice to go on Monday, you know, maybe they could give up Monday to go to church, right? But
I tell you that some coaches they not stop. Just seven day whole week is coaching.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, I've done that before. Long time ago, especially before I was a Christian, right? So I can understand their mentality. It's easy money, right? You make a lot of money. You teach 7 days a week. But we just need to pray for the coaches here in Hong Kong, especially pray for Ryan, because he's actually reaching out to coaches in Hong Kong through our ministry and through his own desires to reach out to the coaches. And how about the families, Ryan, and the people you teach? Do you have a success story you'd like to share with us? Maybe where you've been able to reach out to somebody?
Yes, but that case is in a Christian family. When I starting the lesson, okay, still teaching tennis, but some days I pray and then God tell me, oh, why you not at the starting not praying with them. So I invite them, okay, we starting, can we pray? So they like it, and the kid is so young, and that is teach him to believe God strongly, to build up him to serving Jesus. So I think that that is good. Yeah.
Do you have any material you can give them, or you're not just praying?
Just pray, because the kid is about 5 years old.
Okay.
And the mom is my church sister.
Right.
So just like that, the relationship just like that. So that is good idea. So I give them a material. Yeah.
First they have to learn to read though, right? If they're
five. Yeah.
They have to write, they have to be able to read before you give them material. Now the other thing is, it'd be interesting to hear, that's a really good comment that he made. That would be an easy way to reach out to your students, is just ask them, you know, respect them, because some of them are Christians and some aren't. But even if they're not a Christian, don't be afraid to just say, would you, you know, I'm a Christian as a coach. Would you mind if I pray with you before the lesson starts? I would say most people would say, yeah, that's fine. And even if they're not Christian, of course, some people may say, no, that's not what I want. Respect that, and don't let it go beyond that, but at least you know where they're at spiritually. And if you just say, would you mind if I pray before we start our lesson, and you just bow your head and say a prayer, very short, easy prayer, and then that would be a really good thing to get your student in the habit of. And you know, that would translate to when they play their own matches, because they'll come on the court and they'll pray themselves then. And I think that's a great idea that Ryan had right there.
I have some suggestion is, I think at the starting, the non-Christian, I think you'll make the strong relationship long time, and then so invite them to pray, because some will first you at the early stage some is shy,
right.
oh pray,
right?
Why to pray? But
right.
you at the long time you tell them, I'm a Christian. Okay, you know I'm a Christian. I think have a lesson, have some people have personal have a special difficult, like the mental easy give up, some depression. Okay, so you can start to pray with them to, okay, can we pray, God is help us, so you can at that time, so invite is a
good advice. Now I'm gonna ask, I'm sure many of you watching this will want to hear some Chinese spoken. You're not used to hearing Chinese. I am, because I live here in Hong Kong, and what I'd like to do is just ask Ryan to pray for us a very short prayer in his native language, which is Cantonese, and then we'll close at that. And I just want to say thank you, Ryan, for coming.
Yeah.
Okay. Would you like to do a prayer for us right
now?
Thank you.
天父，求你都去帮助我哋。当我哋成为教练，我哋想传福音嘅时候，求你都赐予你嘅能力。 又似我哋信心咧，当我哋要去同人讲福音嘅时候，都有信心同埋勇气。多谢你听我哋嘅祈祷，奉主名求 ，Amen。
Amen. Now remember, it's not important that you understand what he said. You may not understand the language. It's important though that God understands what he says, and I'm sure that God did understand that prayer. So thank you, Ryan.
Oh. Nice to meet you.